Today, we got paid $5,000 for videos that I made on this device right here. This is the topic of conversation in today's video. I'm here to give you indisputable reasons as to why you should be shooting on your iPhone when presented with the opportunity. The industry will never be the same as what it was before the launch of the iPhone 11. I'm simply talking about the quality of camera that's been introduced into mobile devices over the last few years. I personally never would have thought that I would be making money creating content on an iPhone. I'm not just talking about influencer deals, I'm talking about commercialized content that brands are putting money behind, they're pushing as commercial assets and selling products with. And they were all shot on my phone. As of today, I have completed my fourth contract of the summer. My rent has been paid for the rest of the year just from creating videos on this, straight up. And that is so crazy to me. And so that's what we're gonna talk about today. I'm here to give you indisputable reasons as to why you should be shooting on your iPhone or just your mobile phone in general when presented with the opportunity. First and foremost, you can save so much time by shooting on your phone. I feel like that might be a little obvious, but let me break that down a little bit further. Now, obviously, shooting on this is a lot less effort than trying to set up a DSLR camera. I can't even count the number of times or amazing shots that I've probably missed by not being able to turn this DSLR and get the settings right away. You literally click a single button and you can open up your camera and start filming on this. And on top of that, the files that are created when you are shooting on your phone, they're just so much easier to edit than a C-Log R5 video clip. I'm gonna have to import all that footage, then I'm gonna have to make proxies, and then just like the rendering, the exporting, just everything that I'm working with on those files takes so much longer. It's just so much faster and more fluid to work on a phone. You don't necessarily even have to transfer from your phone to your computer, and you can AirDrop if you're like Apple to Apple, or just edit on an app in your phone. One of the most common questions I've gotten over my lifetime is, what is a good starter camera? Now, if you haven't already invested in a DSLR setup, I highly suggest starting to shoot on your phone or at least upgrading to the iPhone 11 or 11 Pro, whatever's gonna have a variety of lenses for you to use. And not only is this camera gonna be less expensive than a DSLR setup, but the accessories are also going to be just significantly cheaper. Let's talk about ND filters and polarizers. You can get an entire setup of ND filters for your phone for around $100 to $150. That is the cost of a single high quality ND filter for a single lens on your DSLR setup. Gimbals. The Osmo Mobile 4 is also only like $150 versus the Ronin S2, which, I mean, I love that gimbal, but it's $1,000 versus $150. And then lenses. You can get iPhone lenses. You could get a really good iPhone lens for $100. For instance, I have a $10 fisheye lens that I used to use on my old phones versus this 15 to 35 millimeter lens that I have on this camera that's around $3,500 to $4,000. A really good iPhone lens could be around $100, but it's not $3,000, $4,000. Now let's talk about storage. Now, when you're shooting on a DSLR or these bigger cameras, you're taking up a lot more storage space to begin with. And then on top of that, you have to buy more expensive storage space in order to edit off of it efficiently. Or you can just buy like a Google Drive subscription or iCloud, and you can do like a monthly subscription with your phone and then just delete the videos that you're done with. We're talking like $14 versus $400 for 1 terabyte of storage. Let's talk about audience. This I would consider to be secret slash strategy that I implement for specific campaigns. I feel that overproduced content is a deterrent on certain social media platforms. What do I mean by this? Creating content that feels too polished immediately makes you feel like you're producing an ad. I'm not gonna sit around and watch somebody's video just because it was shot on a DSLR. There's a lot of iPhone videos that I find to be way more educational and way more entertaining. Think of TikTok. Like, TikTok wouldn't exist if that weren't true. Viewers are accustomed to seeing ads. You know, we're thrown ads at the beginning of every single YouTube video that we watch. So immediately, as soon as we see these types of videos start to play, we're skipping them. I feel like if you're shooting on a phone, you have this window of opportunity to really start to prove that what they're about to watch has value to it. So I feel like that gives you an opportunity to make something that's different and can actually reach a wider audience. And on top of that, I feel like it allows people to feel that they can make a similar style of content. For instance, The Instagram reels that I produce are all shot on the iPhone. And I love to do that because I want people to feel like they could also do the exact same thing. You know, I don't want people to feel like there's such a barrier to entry to creating good content. And I feel like you really narrow down your audience the moment that they see a DSLR clip. And most importantly, it's fun. It is fun. I have a lot of fun not having to carry an extremely heavy setup and challenging myself to get creative and use this tiny tool and see what it's capable of, because sometimes it blows me away to see what can be created on this device. As creators, I always think it's important to implement restrictions and to implement challenges that you're gonna have to overcome, because that forces us to be creative and to problem solve. We can all create this content. You know, it's just a phone. Pick up your phone, tell the story that you wanna tell. It simply has a deeper rooted connection with a wider audience, in my opinion. Don't feel so limited by not having the most expensive camera on the market. A lot of you watching this have a device that is powerful enough to create videos that are better than what I was able to shoot 5 to 10 years ago. For all of these reasons, whenever I have the opportunity presented to me to recommend that we shoot a project or a campaign on an iPhone, I take it. Believe it or not, our brains are smart enough to adapt to the different types of marketing. So maybe this isn't permanent. Maybe iPhone videos will not last forever, but the fact that we can use it and utilize this opportunity right now, I think is just amazing. The barriers to entry in just the social media age have been lowered even further. So hop on board and take full advantage of it if you've been holding back.